الله الله لا إله إلا الله الله الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي، يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم، وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين، إنك حميد مجيد. عدد خلقك ورضا نفسك وزينة عرشك ومداد كلماتك كلما ذكرك الذاكرون غفل عن ذكرك الغافلون. إلى حضرة الحبيب المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم، وعلى آنية شفاء عرف البلاء ونصر على الأعداء وقضاء الحاجة وتيسير الأمور والقبول وأملا متقبلة، وإلى أرواح من سبقنا إلى رحمة الله بسر سورة الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. الحمد لله. All praises be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who have given us blessings after blessings after blessings in this holy month of Ramadan. With the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His graciousness, we are now in the seventh day of Ramadan. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. May we be amongst those who are consistent in doing our worship in this month, not just in the first 10 days, but even more in the second 10 days, and much, much more worship in the last 10 days. Regarding consistency, let me share with you one of the hadith. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam that once while a man was traveling in the wilderness, he heard a voice in a cloud ordering the angel of the cloud to pour its rain on a particular farm. So the man followed the cloud and saw that it poured its rain on a rocky volcanic plain. All the water gathered in a stream and poured into a farm. The man saw the owner working in that farm and asked him on his name. The name was the same one that he had heard from the cloud. The man then related what he had heard and seen and inquired from the owner of the farm what was special about him that would explain all of this. Given the reason for the inquiry, the owner explained that he would plant his farm and then split the harvest into three equal parts. One part he gave as sadaqah, as charity. The second part he kept for himself and also his family. And the third part he replanted it. Hadith riwayah Muslim. From this hadith, my dear beloved Jama'ah, we could learn from this hadith two important lessons. The importance of consistency in doing good deeds. The man was giving one third of his earnings as sadaqah, as charity on a regular basis. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was sending rain especially for him. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us that the deeds most loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are those that are done regularly, even though they may be few. Aw kama qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, hadith riwayah Bukhari. The second importance of this hadith that we could learn is the importance of sadaqah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was sending rizq, to this man in the form of rain because of his sadaqah, because of his regular sadaqah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala therefore used him as a channel to provide to the needy. My dear beloved jama'ah, money is a trial from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not a sign of person's righteousness, because some of the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were poor and some of the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were rich. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, consistency in doing good deeds are most loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Be it small, but if it is inconsistency, if it is done regularly, it is done every day, every month, subhanallah, it is the best. And in this month of fasting, it is this month of Ramadan, the month of mercy, the month where rewards are multiplied, it is good for us to be consistent in our ibadah, consistent in our tarawih, consistent in reciting the Quran, and also in giving sadaqah. Let us be better Muslim this Ramadan, better than last Ramadan. Let us do more sadaqah charity in this month, in this Ramadan, than last Ramadan. Let us read more pages of the Quran and even understanding the meaning of what we read and even applying them in our daily lives. Dear Jemaah, this is the seventh day of Ramadan. 1 week of Ramadan has passed us. We could not retrieve it back if we even want to. We are left with 23 more days of Ramadan. Let us do not waste these 23 more days of Ramadan, because we do not know whether next Ramadan we will still be here. We will not know whether next Ramadan we will be still alive. Wallahu ta'ala alam. Tayyib. The topic that was given to me is about the first verse of Surah Al-Furqan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا صدق الله العظيم. Which means, blessed is he, يعني Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has sent down the criterion upon his servant, the criterion, the Quran, upon his servant Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that he may be a warner to all nations, that he may be a warner to all alameen, to all worlds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala starts the ayah by using the word tabarakah, blessed. For only with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala we will find blessings upon blessings upon blessings. It is He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who give to His servants countless blessings. For the blessings of sight, sound, smell, taste, and also touch. For you are seeing me today using your eyes, using your sight, for this is a blessing. You are listening to my voice now and listening here and there using the blessing of hearing, using the blessing of sound. You are smelling the food in front of you now using the sense of taste, smell, the blessing of smell. And insyaAllah, ba'dal azan maghrib, selepas azan maghrib, after the call for prayer of maghrib, we will have the sense, the blessings of taste. And even more blessings Allah SWT have blessed upon us. Alhamdulillah, we have rain upon rain, after we have gone through our haze. We have gone through our PSI, we have gone through our patience, we have gone through our salat, our istighfar, and countless of blessings. And this blessing starts even when we have heard our baby's heartbeat, it is a blessing. If we have touched our baby's hand for the first time, it is a blessing. And even in this month of Ramadan, these blessings are enhanced. Our sights are enhanced to the extent we are so observant of the time, much more in this month. We know every second, we are waiting for every second until it is 7:18 for today. Our ears are amplified that the sound of azan could be heard even before it is called. Our sense of smell is widened to a degree we could smell the food 2 blocks away, subhanallah. There are even blessings that are unlocked. We have another sixth sense which is unlocked in this month of Ramadan. For it is the sixth sense, it is the blessing of faith. For subhanallah, because of faith, we did not break our fast in the afternoon. We do not break our fast in the evening. Although if we could, we could do it. But we didn't. It is because of faith. Because we have faith towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We could live our lives as though it is not Ramadan. We could live our lives as normal. Without guarding our tongue, without guarding our eyes from watching things which are unbeneficial, watching YouTube movies after movies after movies. We could do that, but we control ourselves. It is because of faith. Because deep down we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. Deep down we know that the angels are jotting down our good and bad deeds. Because in this month of Ramadan, قال الله تعالى بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. Oh people who believe, oh people of faith, it is prescribed unto you fasting as it is prescribed before you, لعلكم تتقون, so that you could attain taqwa, so you could attain righteousness, so you could attain a God-conscious mind, a God-conscious heart. That is the level of ihsan that we want in this month of Ramadan. What is ihsan? For ihsan is an ta'budu Allah ka'annaka tarah, fa in lam yakun tarah fa innahu yarak. To worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as though we could see Him. But if we could not see Him, we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching us. Nah, alhamdulillah. Praise be to Him, Ya Allah, the giver of all blessings. Allah starts the ayah of Al-Furqan with Tabarak. Blessed be He. The verbal form used here implies on an ongoing blessing, on a permanent blessing, on an eternal blessing. Alladhi nazzala al-furqan. Alladhi nazzala al-furqan. Who sent down the criterion. The verb nazzala, sent down, is a form which applies something which is great. Each of the previous books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was sent down in one time. But the Quran, the Quran, which is another name for the Quran, is Al-Furqan, was revealed gradually. And Al-Furqan also brings the mean gradually. In stages, يعني, ayah after ayah, surah after surah, rulings after rulings. This is more eloquent of greater care for the one whom it is revealed. Al-Furqan, the meaning of Al-Furqan is criterion. Brings the meaning of a standard, a rule, a test on which a judgment or decision can be based. This surah, Al-Furqan, which is also another name, as I mentioned, Al-Quran, it is because it decides between truth and falsehood, guidance and misguidance, right and wrong, halal and haram, lawful and unlawful. تبارك الذي نزل القرآن نزل الفرقان على عبده نزل الفرقان على عبده. Who is this عبد؟ على عبده means to his servant, the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This description is one of praise and commendation and recognition, because here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala connecting him sallallahu alaihi wasallam to himself, describing him sallallahu alaihi wasallam as his devoted servant. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also described him in this manner in surah al-Isra, subhanalladhi asra bi 'abdihi layla, glorified be he who took his servant for a journey by the night. Liyakuna lil alami alamina nazira, that he may be a warner, a reminder to all nations, to all worlds. Mean he sallallahu alaihi wasallam alone has been blessed with this great detailed clear book, which la ya'tihi al-batilu min bayni yadayhi wala min khalfihi tanzilum min hakimin hamid, which falsehood cannot come to it, falsehood cannot come to the Quran from behind it or before it. It is sent down by the all wise, worthy of all praise, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who made it the mighty criterion, single him Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam out to convey it to those who seek the shade of trees, to those who live on the land, to all mankind, nomad and settled alike. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, bu'ithu ila al-ahmari wal aswad, aw kama qala Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I have been sent to the red and the black. And he, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, said, inni utitu khamsan lam yu'tahunna ahadun minal anbiya'i qabli. I, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, have been given five things which no prophet before me was given. Amongst them he mentioned, kana an-nabiyyu yub'athu ila qaumihi khassah wa bu'ithtu ila an-nasi ammah. Before me, a prophet was sent only to his own people, but I have been sent to all mankind. And Allah says, "Qul ya ayyuhan nas, inni rasulullahi ilaykum jami'a." Say, O Muhammad, O mankind, verily I, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, am sent to you all as the messenger of Allah, meaning the one, yani Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, has sent Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the king of all kings, the supreme ruler of the heavens and the earth, who merely says to a thing, be and it will be. He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the one who gives life and causes death, has sent the Furqan, has sent the criterion, has sent the Quran, the truth, the haq, the guidance. To whom? To Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as a warner to all alamin, a reminder for us in this world, in all worlds. And before we end, the takeaways that we could take home: one, Al-Furqan. Al-Furqan is another name for the Al-Quran. It means the criterion, a standard, a rule which a judgment or decision can be based, that decides between truth and falsehood, guidance and misguidance, good and bad, right and wrong, halal and haram, lawful and unlawful. This is not just a mere book. It is a miracle. It is not a book of science, it is a book of science. It is not a book, the Quran is not a book of science, S-C-I-E-N-C-E. It is a book of ayat, it is a book of science, S-I-G-N-S. It is a manual of life, it is a book of guidance. It transforms people to be a better human being. It transforms people to be a more practical Muslim. It is the word of our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the Creator knows better than the creation. Lastly, this book, this Furqan, this Al-Quran, is given down from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to his beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send his graces, blessings, mercy on the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And also his angels too ask Allah to bless and forgive him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. For who are we to not do salawat upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli wa sallim wa bari alayhi wa alayhi. To know him is to know him. To know him subhanahu wa ta'ala is to know him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to get to know his beloved Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is because only Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows Allah more than us. We learn about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And with that, I apologize if I have mistaken or anything. I will end with dua inshallah. Then we will iftar after the azan. We will end with tasbih kafara and surah wal asr and dua inshallah. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilaik. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim wal asr. Innal insana lafi khusr. Illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bil sabr. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'anil azim. Wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi minal ayati wa dhikril hakim. Wa taqabbala minni wa minkum tilawatahu innahu huwa السميع العليم. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات فاستغفروه فيا فوز المستغفرين ويا نجاة التائبين.